If something has not changed for many years, and here it is multiple decades, you need to bring in disruptive innovation. 3R Foundation, which has declared an end date.
So today we have with us Mr. Vineet Nair, who is the former CEO of HCL Technologies and is currently the founder chairman and CEO of Sampark Foundation and author of critically acclaimed management book, Employees First, Customers Second, Turning Conventional Management Upside Down. He is an acknowledged management visionary and has architected HCL's transformation to a $4.7 billion global technology services company with over 85,000 employees that led Fortune to recognize HCL as the world's most modern management. And Mr. Nair was chosen by Fortune magazine for its first ever global executive dream team 2012. Thank you so much for joining us, Mr. Nair. It's a privilege to have you.
Thank you for inviting me.
And just to start with the conversation, so how are you using the professional expertise of yours to solve the critical issues in the country? And what importance do you attribute to the frugal innovation in contemplating the same?
I think one of the critical aspects of people coming from the business end of the spectrum is that they measure results by impact created and not by the effort which goes into the impact. And therefore, that to me is very, very critical in terms of if we are going to put all the energy and effort behind trying to solve a longish problem, do we measure it by the impact we have created? And in the field of education, for the last 25 years, the impact is not visible. The learning outcomes are only going down. The second rule which the business teaches you is if something has not changed for many years, and here it is multiple decades, you need to bring in disruptive innovation. Unless you have a disruptive, innovative idea, the change will not take place. So that's the second thing I bring to the table in thinking about disruptive, innovative ideas. Third, and the most important thing is India is a very large country with about 144 million, 15 crore children in government schools. You know, whenever you multiply a solution by 15 crores, that's a very large number. And therefore, the frugality of your disruptive, innovative idea is very, very critical. So I would believe that frugal innovation, which is disruptive in nature, measuring impact and relentless pursuit of execution to create an impact is something which I believe my, you know, three decades of experience in the business world is helping me bring that learning to the social sector.
Great. And like you mentioned, so anything to take place in India would be like, you know, on a very large scale, the actions that the outcomes that happen out of it. So education as a domain is also an interesting one, because it has a lot of people working in it in one way. And on the other, there's a lot of children or students or beneficiaries that are affected by these innovations or projects. So what was it about the domain of education in particular that motivated you to work it in through Sampark Foundation? And is it a personal motivation behind it, or was it completely out of the lack of, you know, innovative ideas out there in the field?
I think the motivation is both personal and you know, attractiveness to a largest problem we need to solve. There are 144 million children, almost 15 crore children in our about 760,000 government schools. Learning outcome of grade 5 is that about 80% can't do simple addition and cannot read grade 2 text. But more importantly, 37% of children in the government schools drop out from schools by the time they reach grade 5 because they're not able to understand what is happening in the school. With the size and scale of this problem being so large, I automatically was attracted to try and solve a problem which we can solve at scale. The personal story is the fact that my mother is a teacher, has been a teacher for 30 years and has been teaching. And it was her inspiration which made me quit HCL Technologies and dedicate my wealth and my time to trying to solve this problem. The second is my wife, Anupma, who is the brainchild behind our pedagogical approach, is a special educated teacher. And therefore, it made sense that we seem to have within the family the competence of education. I had none. the mindset of implementation and bringing business ideas which I had. And education seemed to be the right place where we potentially could bring about disruptive, inclusive innovation to try and transform at a size and scale which the country had not seen so far. So today we have about 90,000 schools in our program and about 1 crore children in this program. And we have dramatically improved learning outcome for these 1 crore children. We could do that in education, but I don't think that would have been possible had we attempted healthcare, health and hygiene, or agriculture. We didn't have new ideas of disrupting those areas. And that's the reason we chose education.
Amazing. And like you talked about Sambarg Foundation, now coming back to the foundation again. So you mentioned that it's already reached out to more than 90,000 students and schools in the country. So impacting more than 7 million kids in particular. So making it one of the largest, you know, primary school transformation initiatives by any foundation. And how do you plan to expand it further and cater to more millions of kids? Like we talked about before, that India is a huge country and the number of kids are even more for, you know, any intervention to reach on its own. So how do you intend to expand the foundation to be able to cater to the last mile?
So first is, we are a foundation which has declared an end date. We have said that by 2025, we would shut down our shutters. We will close. And therefore, we as a foundation do not exist in perpetuity. We exist for a purpose. And therefore, it is a mission-led organization to try and solve as many problems as we can with for as many children as we can by year 2025. 2025 is the drop dead date for us. And that is also originating out of the limited resources me and my wife are investing in Sambarg Foundation. So our goal is to try and get to 2 crore children in 200,000 schools by year 2025. And I think we are well on our way. As I said, we have 1 crore children in almost 90,000 schools. So we are well on our way to do that. The only thing is, the aspirations have increased now. With coronavirus coming in, I think the size and scale of the problem, if it was X, now it is 10X. Given the fact that the migrant population, children are going back to Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, where the infrastructure of the school is far worse than the urban government school infrastructure. So therefore, we are upping our goals, we are upping our aspirations, and hopefully, we will get to 50 million children, not 20 million children, 5 crore children by year 2025. And that is our aspiration. And I'm sure we'll get to that position.
I'm sure you'll be able to. And talking about the current times that we are in, the COVID-19 pandemic, so it's already crippled a lot of educational institutions in particular, since the, you know, imparting of training cannot happen in person. So a lot of them have moved online. So what is, I would say, the intention of your foundation on how would you like to keep it afloat in terms of reaching out to the children in these current times?
So first is Sambarg Foundation, which is largely funded my wife and me, doesn't have a funding issue. So therefore, you know, we can keep ourselves afloat, and we have doubled our investment during Corona times to try and reach the children. The second, I don't think many people understand what is happening right now. And let me try and take a few minutes to explain what is happening. What is happening is three things. Number one, the children are out of school. Remember, I told you 37% of the children drop out at grade 5 because they don't understand what is happening in the schools. With 1 year away from school, that 37% will suddenly become much larger. And a larger percentage of 15 crore children is a very large population pool, which is going to remain uneducated and go into a labor pool. So that's challenge number one, which Corona has thrown to us. The challenge number two is, as I said, the migrating population has moved at least their families, if not themselves, to areas where the school infrastructure is quite poor compared to the urban government school infrastructure. And therefore, the quality of education being imparted to the children has dramatically dropped. Third, and I think the most important concern which I have, is that all the work which we are doing, which is broadcasting on Doordarshan, sending some WhatsApp messages, attempt on e-learning, sending some videos to children, are not going to create any impact whatsoever unless there is an interactivity involved. I think we are talking too much of what we are doing, but doing very little. And therefore, if our purpose of existence is to create an impact on the children, I don't think we are doing enough. And therefore, we need to go back to design thinking. We need to go back to drawing board, which is what we are doing, and create an interactive digital interface with the children on low-cost technologies for them to be able to interact with the children. So we need to take the physical classroom and make it a digital interactive classroom by creating closed user groups between the child and the teacher. And we need to digitalize that using low-cost technologies rather than have just this one-way attempt which is being made. And, you know, so I think a combination of these three are throwing up significant redesign challenges, re-innovation challenges, design thinking challenges. And if we continue doing what we have done over the last decade, then we'll come up with it not. The problem has suddenly multiplied 10 times, but our solutions remain static and pasted to the past, whereas they need to be more futuristic. So Sampark Foundation is doubling its effort. It is hiring more people, putting in more money into design thinking, innovation, into creating digital interface, in trying to get to these 1 crore children before it is too late. Because I do not want them to drop out of school. Because if they drop out of school, catching them again is going to be very, very difficult.
आपकी मांगों और जरूरतों को ध्यान में रखते हुए हम आपके लिए लेके आए हैं एक और नवाचार, संपर्क बैठक। तो बैठक पर हम एक दूसरे से चलिए कुछ सीखते हैं, कुछ सिखाते हैं। तो देर किस बात की, चलिए शिक्षा को मजेदार बनाएं। आइए मिलते हैं बैठक पर।
And like you touched upon this point of, you know, say education needs to be futuristic. So even the national education policy that came out this year is kind of looking forward in terms of, you know, changing the whole curriculum, the way dissemination happens, the way the learning outcomes are measured. So even in the domain of education, there's a lot that needs to be considered apart from just, you know, imparting the lessons or the curriculum as such. So is there any other aspects that Sampark Foundation particularly is looking into, or something that you particularly, apart from education, are interested in? So say, if you're partnering with any organization for skills or employability or something to just, you know, take it a step further from just education in school.
I think there are three things the National Education Policy says which look very attractive to me. Number one, they said we need to move from rote learning to application-based learning so that people can create self-generated employment, which is a great point. Second is the focus on assessment, that we need to move away from test, quiz, fear-based assessment to participative developmental assessment. That's point number two. Point three is that education should result into creating jobs. Now, these are the three areas which Sampark Foundation is gone back to design board and is really rethinking its approach. The first which we are doing is we are launching a flipped classroom where the teacher would be able to send the content to the child before the child comes to the classroom, interact with the child on a Facebook kind of a digital medium, and therefore that the conversation in the class is around application of those concepts and doing gativiti around those concepts rather than, you know, teaching the concept from scratch. On assessment, we are just launching a fairly large-ish initiative where we are digitalizing the entire assessment around Kaun Banega Crorepati and getting the assessment at home on an IVR, you know, so that a child can dial in and play the game Kaun Banega Crorepati and learn math, learn English, learn science and do that. And the third which we are doing, which I think is we're bringing in STEM for everyday life. Now, how do you build things, right? How do you build things and how can you sell those things? So we are using the STEM principles to help children learn entrepreneurship skills to be able to build that. So these are our three responses to the National Education Policy. And the first we will start rolling out in October itself. And I think by December, all three programs would have rolled out.
And just coming to the end of the conversation and summing everything up in terms of what the foundation is doing and how you are kind of inclined towards the domain of education. So what would you say is something that the future holds for education and the students in particular? And how is it that the Sampark Foundation envisions the future of education?
I think to all the people who are listening, I come from the corporate background where flying on private jets and eating in French restaurants was the norm. And now sitting on the middle seat of IndiGo is a joy. We all must understand the size and scale of the other India. The problems in other India is very, very large, very, very large. We cannot leave it to the government to solve it and be these pedestrians, who is watching the traffic run by. We cannot do that because the problem, the size and scale of the problem is too large for the government to handle. So every single Indian has to contribute intellectually, not financially, intellectually to try and solve this problem. You can take a small problem, you can take a large problem. We have picked up education as a problem to try and solve it. And I'm telling you that the only way we can solve this problem is through innovation. And the way the innovation happened is a lot of my HCL colleagues are contributing with their ideas, with their technology, with, and my friends in Harvard Business School, my friends in Innovation Labs, all have come together to try and solve this problem. The future of India is secure only if every single Indian is secure in the knowledge that he or she will get employment. And the only way he or she will get employment is if we educate her and him to be employable and to create self-employment. And therefore, the onus on all of us who have been fortunate and have gained out of the Indian education system to earn the wealth, to earn the recognition, and to earn the intellect, have to now turn the other way. Turn not towards creating and earning more money, but turn the other way to try and see if we can pull up the other 300, 400 million Indians who are being left behind and pull them up and bring them along with us. That is the only way our country will be great.
Great. And that just brings us to the close of the conversation. It's been a privilege to have you, Mr. Nair. And thank you so much for such insightful insights into the domain of education and how you're working towards it with a personal motive as well as something that you envision to even bring about a change for the millions of students across the country. Thank you so much.
How do you solve the problem that faces 144 million children in India's government schools, where 6 out of 10 cannot read grade 2 text and 8 out of 10 cannot do simple math sums, despite doubling of investment in education over the last decade? Our design thinking assumption was that if we ignite the classroom by bringing innovation in the interface of the teacher and the child, and implement it at scale in partnership with the government, we can solve the problem. This gave birth to Sampark Smart Shala with 5 innovative elements, including an audio box with a voice mascot called Sampark Didi, and a bot-enabled mobile app that works without internet, combined with extensive teacher training and rigorous real-time monitoring. This has helped us achieve over a 40% increase in learning outcomes for 7 million children in 76,000 rural schools at a cost of just $1 per child per annum.
Classes ke andar enthusiasm create karna bahut important hota hai taki bachche acche se pad sake aur iske liye jo TLMs hain wo hamari backbone ka kaam karte hain kyunki wo bachchon ko bahut hi easily samjhane mein hamari help karte hain. संपर्क फाउंडेशन की अगर बात करें तो इंग्लिश किट में जो ऑडियो किट ऑडियो हमें मिला हुआ है टूल संपर्क दीदी का, वो बहुत ही इफेक्टिवली हमारी क्लासेस में हमारी हेल्प कर रहा है. बच्चों की लिसनिंग स्किल्स उससे बहुत अच्छी डेवलप हो पा रही हैं. मैथ्स किट की अगर बात करूँ तो उसके अंदर काउंटर्स, नंबर लाइंस, पैटर्न्स वगैरह जो हैं वो बच्चों के कॉन्सेप्ट्स को बहुत ईजिली क्लियर कर पा रहे हैं.
However, 7 million is a small fraction and we have to reach the rest before it is too late.